So some of the things we listen to the original, if it's a dub, we'll listen to the original Japanese for the register, the cadence of what they're doing. Sometimes you want to go against type. If they're doing something that's a high register, it might be funnier if you did a lower register. But like with Kaiba, it wasn't the voice that they were looking for so much. It was the attitude. When I was directing the show, I was brought on to just, you know, I was not the actor in the show. So we were casting for the role of Kaiba. And I auditioned a lot of my favorite, you know, voice actor friends. We went through a lot of different auditions, and the producer who had the final say kept saying, I'm not hearing what I'm looking for, I'm not hearing what I'm looking for. And so finally, I said, you know, I think I can do this. I didn't want to double dip and be like the director and the co-star of the show, but we also had a production time crunch to get the show on the air, and I'm thinking, Kaiba's in the whole first episode, we got to figure this out. And so I said, let me dub half the show, and if you don't like it, we'll start from scratch again, but if we do like it, we'll be halfway to finishing and being on time. And so I did it, and he came in and listened and said, that's exactly what I wanted. And what I knew was, it wasn't this character voice I was doing, it was the personality behind it. So it comes down to the acting first, and the other stuff is the whipped cream, right? Sometimes we come up with accents or dialects, things like that, because we want to add some flavor to it. But honestly, I do more voiceover work in my entire career talking like me than I do about any character voice. But Kaiba is an exaggeration of real Eric.